Good enough is good enough? Scratch that. Good enough sucks. Yeah, that's right. Never go with your first edit because it can always get better. But managing dozens of rough cuts and emails is messy, so that's the problem that Dropbox solves with the brand new app and synced integration to DaVinci Resolve called Dropbox Replay. So let me show you how to collaborate with the client to manage review and approval notes directly within your DaVinci Resolve timeline. Stick around until the end and I'll go over some opportunities to explore unmet potential and how this differs from Frame.io. If you don't already have one, get started by creating a Dropbox account. They minimize it, but you can click the link at the bottom for a basic 2GB plan, which I suggest you start with. And the reason I recommend the basic plan to start is that Replay currently does not count against your storage quota. Dump as many videos into there as you'd like for the whopping price of free 99. Yeah, this costs nothing to try out. No, this is in beta, so I'm sure this is gonna change, and here's how the pricing stacks up against the obvious tool they're trying to compete with, the Adobe-owned Frame.io. Dropbox is much cheaper per month for the same amount of storage, but it's also not as fast as Frame.io. Anyways, now that you have an idea of the potential future pricing, let's hook it up. Go to replay.dropbox.com after you've signed into your Dropbox account and click to get Replay. You might want to go ahead and bookmark replay.dropbox.com at this point for quick access. In DaVinci Resolve, go to Preferences, stay on the System tab, and down to Internet Accounts. These options here automatically upload videos to these services if you authenticate here and use the Deliver Page presets. So even though Dropbox Replay is a separate app from Dropbox, you still authenticate with the same Dropbox credentials. So click to sign in. Go ahead and sign in to link Dropbox with DaVinci Resolve and click Allow so Resolve can be a connected app. We'll skip the editing process and jump to the Deliver page to export and upload directly to Replay. Scroll over a little and choose the Dropbox Replay icon and not the classic Dropbox icon. Type a file name that matches your timeline so you can always track back to your project. This is just good editing life advice. Click the browser to set the file location to write on your disk, change your resolution if necessary, and most importantly, check the box to upload directly to Dropbox Replay. Click Add to Render Queue, and feel free to add more videos to batch upload if necessary. Quick side note, this is the only way to batch upload files into Replay at this moment. You can't do this on the website. Anyway, select them and render all. Go to the Workspace drop-down menu and choose Background Activity to see an upload progress window which is visible on any page in Resolve, so you can continue working on other pages while a large file is uploading. The Dropbox website has tabs at the top for Your Work and Shared With You. These let you know who owns the file. There's three ways to add files to Your Work area. Click the blue Add Files button to pull a new copy of the file from your traditional Dropbox, which you could have uploaded with Dropbox's Smart Sync if you're smart. No, for real, don't use a web browser when you can avoid it. It's way slower. And it's important to know that Dropbox Replay videos are a different instance of that classic Dropbox video asset. So if you delete it from one spot, it's not deleted from the other. The second way is to upload any video or audio file from your disk using that same drop-down menu, or upload with the Resolve integration like we just did. You'll notice the integrated files from DaVinci Resolve are dumped on the root of your work page. On the website, you can click to create a project, give it a name, and then click and drag the files into the project. Inside the project folders, you can have more folders to organize things further and navigate back out with the breadcrumb trail in the upper left of the website. You have a list view and thumbnail view. Sorry, no hover scrub, at least not of yet, and a three-dot menu lets you share review links to files. Click the share button. And the review and comment option is what I'd like to show you. Just copy and paste that link into an email and send it over to your client or team member. One thing to note here is you can't share folders currently, only individual files per link. After clicking on the shared link, you get a dedicated player, which is way better than the classic Dropbox video player. J, K, and L, they work similar to editing shortcuts, but J jumps back 5 seconds and L moves forward 5 seconds. K and spacebar are going to play and pause, but one of my favorite things is that the period and comma keys on the keyboard are going to move just one frame at a time. This is just like the YouTube player, by the way. You can set comments for a specific frame and see the timecode value at the bottom navigation. There's also a variable speed option to review a video faster, and the all-important status dropdown to keep track of the work in progress for needs review, in review, and approved. Maybe this will help us have less of those timelines named final, really final, master, finish, done, last one.mp4. Or you can just iterate versions with numbers like I do. Oh, and by the way, I'm Chadwick, and if you made it this far, welcome. This is Creative Video Tips, which is all about helping you create videos that make a difference and stand out. Subscribe if you're into that and DaVinci Resolve, and so you don't miss out on next week's tip. Now let's take a look at how the markers sync up between the website and Resolve. So long as you uploaded using the DaVinci Resolve preset on the deliver page and have an internet connection, your timeline and video on replay are synced up for comment markers. To add a comment on the website, pause on the frame you want to make a note, click in the box to speak your mind, and hit Command Return, that keyboard shortcut, or just hit that blue post button to send a message. You can also draw on the frame to call out a specific object, and Resolve's annotation feature can see that markup over in Resolve. Replay will also send an email notification for each comment to the video owner to alert them to get back to work. On the flip side, back in Resolve, you'll notice the new purple markers. Double-click it to open and interact with it, or while the playhead is over it, tap M on the keyboard to launch into the comment marker box without moving your hands off the keyboard. Navigate to the next Dropbox comment marker with shift up and down arrows. If the timeline has lots of regular markers, you can limit the visibility to seeing just the Dropbox comments by going to View, Show Markers, uncheck all, and then back to View, Show Markers, and check Dropbox. Another pro tip is to initiate a new Dropbox marker from the Resolve timeline by right-clicking on the timeline, add marker, and down to Dropbox. Add a note, and it'll appear on the website. To speed this up, set a keyboard shortcut under keyboard customization. Type Dropbox in the search field. I set mine to Command-Shift-D, so then I can quickly interact with my client by hitting Command-Shift-D on the timeline to type a quick note. This chat window also has a to-do list, so you can check off a completed note or delete it altogether. One more pro tip is to make revisions on a duplicate of the timeline. Thanks to Daddy Boss, who in the comments last week let me know that the command duplicate item can be set for duplicating timelines. So now I set up Option D to duplicate timeline by using the keyboard customization window. You'll lose reference to the original comment markers if you start making trims and you don't duplicate the timeline. No need to dwell on this because replay is still in beta, but here's my quick list of opportunities to explore the unmet potential. Versioning support is terrible. You add a new version by clicking on the video version number and uploading the file, but it doesn't show the file name of the new file, so you can't track back at all. There's no comparison tools, and you can't integrate with the new version from DaVinci Resolve. There's no batch uploading unless you queue it from Resolve, so it's not ideal for uploading dailies. Organization into projects has to happen after you upload from Resolve, and the client always has a download option from the shared link. What if they download a work in progress and publish the wrong final version? Sorting, it's limited on the website to update times. Shared links are limited to a single video file, as far as I can tell. And there's no iPhone app. However, I'm super pumped to use Dropbox Replay despite the current limitations. I've been a Frame and Dropbox user pretty much since both ever existed, and Dropbox Replay just makes more financial sense for those already invested into a Dropbox workflow or that just value price over speed. I think Frame excels where Aspera overprices itself for dailies delivery, and Dropbox is an excellent option for review and approval or just archiving old work, you know? Thanks so much for watching. Check out the video that YouTube thinks you're going to enjoy on screen right now. And because there's so much more to learn, I'll see you in the next video.